Hello, today we will discuss the handover techniques for LTE and LTE Advanced system. This presentation will start with quick introduction, and after that we will discuss the existing handover techniques for 3G systems, and we'll move to the advanced handover method that are proposed for LTE and LTE Advanced systems. The long-term evolution project LTE was introduced in 2004. The motivation for the LTE was the desire for a reduction of cost per bit, flexible use of new and existing frequency band, reduction of power consumption, and support of high mobility speeds. In wireless communications, mobile stations often change cells during the conversation because the mobile station moves all the time. Such movement causes the process called handover. During this process, mobile switching center automatically transfers the call between two different cells, and another base station starts to serve the call. The main requirements to process handover include the following objectives. Handover must be performed successfully and as infrequently as possible and be imperceptible to the users. The handover mechanism can be divided into two major groups. Handover can be vertical or horizontal and hard or soft. Vertical or inter-system handover is performed then mobile station moves between different cellular systems. For example, the switching of the serving mobile switching center from microcell to macrocell system. During the horizontal handover or intra-system handover, the call transfers only between different cells of one cellular system. The hard, soft, and softer handovers are the main types of handover techniques that are currently used in 3G systems. Hard handover utilizes the concept break before make. During the hard handover, the mobile station can be served only by one base station at any time. Only then connection with old base station is released, the connection with new base station can be performed. The soft handover technique or make before break method supports two connections at one time. While mobile station is served by old base station, the new connection can be set up and mobile station can select between received signal from several base stations. Softer handover is a special case of soft handover, and when softer handover is performed, the mobile station switches the channel between different sectors of one cell. Now let's discuss the handover techniques for LTE system. Soft handover can be used only in the CDMA systems. Therefore, the LTE and LTE Advanced system are currently used the hard handover technology. However, the hard handover has high outage probability and high data loss. Therefore, the advanced handover techniques are proposed. Today we will discuss semi-soft, fractional soft, multi-carrier handovers, and prediction-based handover. Let's start with semi-soft handover. Semi-soft handover is a possible solution for LTE systems. It utilizes microdiversity method that also is known as site selection diversity transmission. The total bandwidth is divided into data and control bands, as shown on the picture. After that, this band is divided into several sub-bands, which are assigned to each base station by using the frequency reuse concept. The control band contains the system and control parameters that are needed for the cell search and handover. On this picture, the location of mobile station is divided into four stages that depends on pilot signal strength. At the stage 1, the signal from base station 1 is stronger than from base station 2. The difference in strength is greater than threshold. At the stage 2, the signal from base station 1 is still stronger but less than threshold and located in the handover region. At stage 3, the signal from base station 2 became stronger, but the difference is within threshold. At the last stage, stage 4, the signal from base station 2 is much stronger than threshold, and mobile station is now served by base station 2. Based on migration region division, the semi-soft handover can be compared with the hard and soft handover techniques. On this picture, this picture represents the comparison of three handover techniques. During the hard handover, the mobile station is served by only one base station at any time. At stage 3, mobile station crosses over the cell boundary, but still serves by base station 1. And it continues to serve by base station 1 until the pilot difference is greater than the marginal pilot difference. Soft handover technique allows two base stations serve the mobile station in the second and third stages. The mobile station simultaneously receives signal from both base station over the handover region. The situation continues until the difference in signals will become larger than threshold. The semi-soft handover is a hybrid of the soft and hard handover techniques. During the semi-soft handover, the data is selectively transmitted from one of the two base stations. So at stage 2 and 3, the mobile station sequentially performs a connection with the base station which has the stronger pilot signal. The number of users that are served by each base station is relatively reduced compared to the case of soft handover because of base station selection process. Semi-soft handover can support high-speed data services. It has lower outage probability than hard and soft handovers and has a smaller handover delay than hard handover. But it requires the fixed bandwidth partition for LTE system. And handover delay may be increased in case of high traffic. Fractional soft handover is the improved handover scheme that utilizes the carrier aggregation technique. The basic concept of the fractional soft handover is to sort the service on voice over IP and non-voice over IP services. Voice over IP service is served by source and target base station simultaneously, while non-VoIP service can be served by either source or target base station at one time. Fractional soft handover significantly reduces the outage probability comparing with hard and soft handovers. Saves radio resource, has better power consumption comparing with soft handover, maintains the quality quality of service of voice over IP services and improve spectrum efficiency. The next handover technique what we'll discuss is multi-carrier handover. Picture on a slide represents a basic concept of multi-carrier handover. While mobile station moves from base station 1, the pilot signal from this base station becomes weaker. At the position 1, the carrier 1 of the mobile station activates the carrier 2, and this carrier starts the searching process for all available base station and measure the strength, the signal strength from each of base station. At position when mobile station passes the point, there is a signal strength from two base station I equal. The carrier two selects the target base station and list from the list and start the handover process. When signal strength from base station 2 becomes stronger, then from base station 1 and reach hysteresis level, the carrier 2 completes the handover and the carrier 1 removes connection for the base station 1. Multi-carrier handover can support the high data rate service and increase the cell capacity, as well as perform the fast and seamless handover. The last technique of what we'll discuss today is prediction-based handover. This technique was proposed for relay-enhanced LTE advanced system. Such system suggests the placement of the relay nodes near the edge of the cellular network to improve link qualities of cell edge user equipment. The fixed reporting time from the user equipment to evolved node base station is considered inflexible for the existing LTE advanced standard. This reporting time can be too long to provide an immediate handover decision. Therefore, prediction-based handover scheme was proposed. It allows in-node base station to make potential handover decision between the reporting times. The channel qualities during the reporting period are predicted based on the partially observable Markov decision process. The following objectives are included to prediction-based handover. That is maximizing received signal to interference plus noise ratio and minimizing system energy consumption with and without consideration of energy outage of relay nodes. On the left figure, you can see the handover for relay-based networks. On the right picture, right picture represents the division on reporting periods for conventional handover scheme and for prediction-based handover scheme. Prediction-based handover allows to in-node base station to make handover decision without complete measurements report, while the conventional handover schemes, the in-node base station make handover decision only after receiving the measurements report. We proposed prediction-based handover scheme uses the several prediction periods within one reporting time, which allows the in-outbay station make the handover decision based on the predicted link quality. Prediction-based handover has better outage probability and energy consumption, and user equipment can benefit more from better channel qualities. So in this presentation, we discussed several advanced handover techniques. Each of techniques can reduce outage probability, improve energy and power consumption and spectrum efficiency. And also they can support the high data rate services and therefore can be used in LTE and LTE advanced systems. Here you can see the list of references that was used for this presentation and for project paper. Thank you for attention. Goodbye.